the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, we gather for a particular occasion this evening at the Baccalaureate Mass of the class of 2023 at Ave Maria University. To you, the members of that class, know that you will be in my prayers throughout this Mass, that you will be successful in responding to the call that the Lord has given you, and also in the vocations that you choose to go forward in. And as we begin this holy sacrifice, let us all take a few moments now, calling to mind those times when we have sinned and asking God's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have taught the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that in the same Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Paul came to Antioch in Pisidia, he said in the synagogue, "My brothers, children of the family of Abraham, and those others among you who are God-fearing, to us this word of salvation has been sent. The inhabitants of Jerusalem and their leaders failed to recognize him. And by condemning him, they fulfilled the oracles of the prophets that are read Sabbath after Sabbath. For even though they found no grounds for a death sentence, they asked Pilate to have him put to death. And when they had accomplished all that was written about him, they took him down from the tree and placed him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead, and for many days he appeared to those who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. These are now his witnesses before the people. We ourselves are proclaiming this good news to you, that what God promised to our fathers, he has brought to fulfillment for us, their children, by raising up Jesus. As it is written in the second Psalm, 'You are my son, this day I have begotten you.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mm-hmm. I myself have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. The Lord said to me, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Allow me to begin by saying it's truly a blessing to be here with all of you, particularly with the class of 2023 from Ave Maria University. I wish to greet warmly that class, the individual members of it, your families, especially your parents, if they're able to be here, who sacrificed, made it possible for you to be here at Ave Maria University. I greet the faculty and the staff of the university who have educated and formed you over the years you have been here. They have really given so much of themselves so that you graduates can realize your fullest potential. And for that, we are grateful to the faculty. I greet our president, Mark Mittendorf, Mrs. Mittendorf, our founder, Tom Monahan, here this evening, fellow Board of Trustee members, and Pat Rainey, chairman of the Board of Trustees, who's unable to be with us this evening. I know that in the course of your studies, you came across Vatican Council. You talked about it, maybe theology classes, maybe history, maybe in some other aspect. You did some research for a project, and you used some of the council documents. I think it's key to understanding the Second Vatican Council that it was about evangelization. It was about a missionary spirit that at the time missionary referred to, say, outside our own country. It doesn't really anymore. It refers to kind of more of a home turf in so many ways. But one of the privileged documents that we have that came out of that Vatican Council II was Lumen Gentium, the light unto the nations. And really, the whole idea of the document was to bring the light of Christ to the nations of the world, to all the people, to make up, should we say, an effective evangelization to go out throughout the whole world. Now, if we take a microcosm of the last 4 years of your life, graduates, you've been here at Ave Maria University. The nation, the nations, it was here. That light of Christ that was to be imparted to you, and I thank the faculty and so many others, the priests, for doing that. It happened here. Here is where, in a sense, you lived out that document from the Vatican Council. You were evangelized here at Ave Maria Community. Sometimes it was by a faculty member, sometimes a priest, sometimes by one of your fellow students who encouraged you maybe to reach out through some service hours or just to go with them to the chapel to pray for a time. A Catholic university is one in which Christ holds really the central, should we say, the central integration and organizing place of all the circles of the disciplines and the activities of the university. Has to be Christ-centered. You know, it's so often we see windows, rose windows that are done in churches, and the center of that many times is Christ. Everything goes out from that. And I have a feeling, graduates, that during your 4 years, that has been the case here. At least it is my prayer. And in this relationship with Christ and the other disciplines you would run into, there, hopefully these disciplines were celebrated and explored with an enthusiasm in terms of their value, but also the idea that where was the role of Christ within that particular discipline? In this environment, the understanding of God has to be one that God is the foundation upon which all disciplines are built. I'm not going to go into explaining that. I think you understand that. But I do think we see in our world today any number of academic circles where a discipline is presented, no room for God in that. No belief in God, maybe, in that department at a particular university. Not here. You were blessed to have that influence. The primary purpose, I believe, of a Catholic university is to evangelize. Yes, to teach the subject matter, whatever it may be. But the primary purpose of a Catholic university is to declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ, the Lordship throughout the community, but also to leave each one of you graduates with the understanding that that Lordship of Christ should reign in your heart, in your mind, and most importantly, in your soul, as to who you are and who you are becoming. In the first reading that was read for us this evening from the Acts of the Apostles, and there's a number of readings like that throughout this Easter season, we see that the world, they didn't accept Jesus in his time, clear and simple. They didn't. They put him on a cross. We know that. They took him down from the tree, we hear. It's a very polite way back in that day to say Christ was crucified, because it was so grotesque to them. They say they took him down from the tree, placed him in a tomb. But God raised him up from the dead. Sometimes, and even in some theological circles, and maybe you've heard it, you certainly will, some will say the resurrection of Jesus Christ, just a myth. It's something spiritually charged as a story, and it signals that the cause of Jesus goes on, and that his disciples, well, they remember him fondly. Let's put it that way. It's written that way at times, but I think we need to stop and take a look at, you know, it certainly undermines the purpose of the education that you've received. And you have to see that, because you're going to hear it out in the world. You have to see that and understand that the role of the university that I noted, a Catholic university, and you've had that experience here, that university evangelizes. It brings to the faith, if we could say, the good news that Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, and that the light of Christ is with us, with you, with me, with all of us, and with your community here at Ave Maria University. You know, I think too many times we see ourselves maybe alone in a life. Christ repeatedly spoke of the community. Yes, he went off alone and prayed, but it was the community of believers that came together. C.S. Lewis says that those who challenge the resurrection as a myth have not read many myths. What do I mean by this? Stories are told, these myths, to express maybe a general rule or some truth about life, nature, philosophy. They begin these myths with once upon a time, or maybe a more updated version is a long time ago in a place far, far away. And then the myth goes on. The first reading that we heard today from the Acts of the Apostles didn't say once upon a time. It didn't speak of a land or a time long ago, maybe in a galaxy far, far away. To us, the word of salvation has been given. Salvation for yourselves, for those you love, for this community that gathers here, for this university. You know, the individuals there, they ask why Pilate has condemned Jesus. They asked Pilate to condemn him, let's be honest. And he did. And when all is accomplished, they want to say that, well, maybe he was one of the great prophets. But they took him down from the tree, we heard, and laid him in a tomb. God raised him from the dead. He appeared to those who came to know him after his time of rising from the dead. These were people who had moved up from Galilee to Jerusalem with Jesus. You know the stories, you've read scripture. Christ appeared to any number of them after his resurrection. They were startled. They didn't know what to think. But they knew it was not a myth. It was reality. And how they had to put that together. When Paul speaks about the fact that we ourselves have proclaimed the good news that God has provided to us, we who came up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem, Paul went on himself to be a martyr. You know, if we take somebody, I wonder how many martyrs there were for Hercules. I have a feeling there were none. None that I ever heard of. There are not martyrs to mythical figures and characters. All who knew Jesus were those who, once they have had that encounter with Christ, they stayed engaged. Many of them gave their lives as martyrs to follow Jesus, to stay faithful to that man of God they knew, that Savior they knew. The same man of God, the same Savior that has been revealed to you here at Ave Maria University. The good news, really, is that the heart of evangelization, the heart of Christianity, is within the resurrection. And it determines who you are and who you are becoming. You know who you are. Today you graduate from Ave Maria University, and that's an accomplishment. Who you are becoming. You have many talents that you will come to know as you mature, as you choose a profession, as you decide exactly who will you be. We have to understand in this process of choosing who we will be that Jesus said who he was. And he is the one to whom that really our affection, our love is due and must be given. He is the one to whom we share or give our whole life. Whole life, I speak about our minds, our wills, our public lives, our private lives, our passions. We are to hand that over to the Lord. Why is it important that at this Mass, a baccalaureate Mass, maybe that we celebrate for graduates, that we speak of this document, Lumen Gentium, to bring the light of Christ to the nations? As I look all of you, and you look very professional, very well accomplished, finished, should I say, seated here. You prepare to be doctors, lawyers, engineers, technicians, leaders in the world of finance and business, I hope priests, religious, a whole range of activity. All which is good and which calls forth the talents that God has given to you and that has, should we say, have been honed and sharpened here at Ave Maria University by the administration, the work of the faculty, and yes, your work also. You had to take the time to invest that. What are we finally meant to do with the training and formation that you have received here at Ave Maria University? Really, in the various spheres that you will choose to enter into, it is my prayer that you will use your influence of faith to make the light of Christ present there. To make the light of Christ present in whatever position, whatever vocation you may move forward with. That's what this experience, part of what your experience here, has prepared you to do. You attend the Catholic University. Early on, I defined what are some of the assets of that. You go forth, baccalaureate, graduate students, to, in a sense, sanctify the world, as Vatican II said. You are part of that. You've been given the opportunity through the teaching of others to receive the skills to go forward to do it. And now you must do it yourselves. Do not see the work you do mainly as secular or just something that makes a living for you. No, you bring the light of the risen Christ into that environment. You've received the training, the dedication of individuals to give you those skills to allow you to do that in your life. And now you have to set out to do it. To bring into the sphere where you enter, whatever profession, make it a place where God is rightly praised, where God is rightly recognized. As you have been educated and evangelized here at Ave Maria University, you are to go forth as agents of that same evangelization, agents of that same belief, willing to instill that into coworkers, as you did with classmates here. Don't think you somehow have to stop that now that you go out into the world. It becomes ever more necessary. It is my prayer that you will be blessed in whatever vocation you choose, whatever work you choose, but that you will also take up the challenge to render the light of Christ, wherever it may be you find yourself, into that environment. May you be blessed in that challenge. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Please stand. The Lord is the shepherd who knows each one of his flock by name. Let us offer our prayers to God, trusting in his personal love for us.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that the Holy Spirit may strengthen him to courageously guide the church in the fullness of Catholic truth and holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For men and women who struggle for human rights, that they may never follow false leaders or ways of violence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, the hungry, the lonely, and those who do not yet know the infinite mercy of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families of this community and those gathered here, that they may encourage and support vocations to the priesthood and religious life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters in purgatory who await our prayers and offerings, and for the most forgotten souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our graduating class of 2023, that the hearts of Jesus and Mary will guide each one of them personally in fulfilling their roles at the service of the church, family, and society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Most gentle Father, you guide us along the right path. Your Son is always there beside us. Comfort us by granting these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctify, we pray, O Lord, the offerings made here, and cleanse our hearts by the light of the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Mortem tuam, annunciamus Domine, et tua resurrectionem confitem.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Paul II, St. Mother Teresa of Calcutta, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Franco, our Bishop, the other bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Father, peace be with you. Peace be with you. Deacon, peace be with you. Father, peace be with you.
Outstanding.
On your stay, with your legs
miserere nobis. On your stay, with your legs miserere.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. The body of Christ. Blood of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
The mother of Anna Ferrari, please come to the back of the church. The mother of Anna Ferrari.
Let us pray.
Lord our God, who have been pleased to nourish us with heavenly food, pour, we pray, the delights of your Spirit into the recesses of our hearts, that what we have devoutly received in time, we may profess as a gift for eternity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
I'd just like to invite our president, Mark J. Middendorf, and our chancellor, Thomas S. Monahan, to please come forward for some closing remarks.
What a joy it is to be with you all today. I know you see my name in the program to give some remarks here. A couple days ago, I was in the Adoration Chapel praying what I might say, and the thought occurred to me to invite our founder and chancellor, Thomas S. Monahan, to give these remarks in my stead. So without further ado, Thomas S. Monahan.
Be sorry. I have three challenges for you graduates. The first is, to the extent you can, to go to Mass every day for the rest of your life. The second is to say a rosary every day for the rest of your life. And the third is to go to confession at least once a month for the rest of your life. And if you don't know why that's important, you wasted 4 years here. Thank you.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. We have protected against the wicked snares of the devil. We have the kingdom come to pray.